This show, out of other shows that I know that I've done in the past, it's a lot more magical. The set itself, just the colors and the lights and the setting, just screams very magical, very whimsical. Even the costumes. I mean, Ariel's running around in all blue with feathers and twigs and netting. It's a very magical show, but it's also a very complex show. A lot more complex, I know, than other things that I've done here.
I've only been in a few shows here, and what's great about them is that they've been fairly minimalist, and they've been very intimate shows, and not as grand as this show is. And it's a great synthesis of realism and surrealism and the dichotomy between the two. And it's quite a paradoxical show, I think, between what's real and what's magic, what's mm-hmm. fantasy and what's not, what's a nightmare and what's a dream. And there's a lot to be said about that. And I think the set and the production itself really reflects
and
that.
Shakespeare is meant to be acted, it's meant to be performed, it's meant to be lived. And I never really realized how, once you get the hang of the language, how easy it is to really live in the words. Because they're dense on paper, but they're not dense in your heart when you speak them. And when you know what you're saying, like, it's beautiful. It really
taught
is.
It taught me a lot about how relevant and how transcendent Shakespeare is by nature. There's a reason that he's lived on for so long, and there's a reason why so many people love his characters and the stories and the themes that are brought about. And doing The Tempest, and really the core of it being about reconciliation and forgiveness, I found to be profoundly incredible to work on. Community coming together after a huge traumatic event, as opposed to holding on to their hatred or their reservations toward people, is, like I said, something profoundly incredible and all the more important to be talked about. And that's what I'm really proud of the show for doing.